ठीक है।
सर प्रोसीड कीजिए सर। हेलो सर, प्रोसीड कीजिए
हाँ
सर।
ठीक है। नमस्कार, मैं अजय ठाकुर, आई एम अजय ठाकुर, साइंटिस्ट एफ एंड हेड डिवीजन ऑफ जेनेटिक्स एंड ट्री इम्प्रूवमेंट फॉरेस्ट रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट देहरादून। टुडे इन हॉट टॉक फोर्टिट्यूड आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट ऑन बैम्बू वैल्यूएबल रिसोर्स फॉर रूरल डेवलपमेंट। सो हाउ आई पुट बैम्बू, आई मीन सी दिस इज क्वाइट वंडरफुल प्लांट, वंडर प्लांट। इट्स ग्रास बट इट्स अ वुडी ग्रास, इट्स नॉट लाइक अदर ग्रास। यू गेट प्लेंटी ऑफ वुडी मटेरियल एंड स्ट्रेंजली द ग्रोथ, इट इज वन ऑफ द फास्टेस्ट ग्रोइंग थिंग ऑन अर्थ, स्पेशली वेन यू कंसिडर प्लांट। जस्ट इमेजिन, इट इज समथिंग लाइक इफ यू आर, आई मीन जस्ट इमेजिन इन वन डे यू कैन गेट मोर देन हाफ मीटर ग्रोथ, और इन सर्टन केस इट्स इन अ वीक यू हैव फाइव मोर देन 5 मीटर ग्रोथ, इजंट इट? इट्स अमेजिंग। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू गिव ऑन दैट एंड गिविंग सम ग्लिम्सेस ऑन यू टिल हाउ इट इज, व्हाट इज द ग्लोबल सिनेरियो ऑफ बैम्बू, वेयर वी स्टैंड, व्हाट वी डू इन प्रोपोगेशन, हाउ वी डू कल्टिवेशन, एंड देर आर सम एस्पेक्ट ऑफ यूटिलाइजेशन। सो इकोनॉमिक इम्पॉर्टेंस, इफ यू सी दिस इज अ ग्लोबल मार्केट, दिस इज एन एस्टिमेट बाई ग्रांडव्यू रिसर्च डॉट कॉम, दे एस्टिमेटेड अराउंड 68.8 बिलियन इन 2018। सो दिस इज ह्यूज 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 मार्केट। बट इफ यू कंसिडर वेर वी आर इन इंडिया, वी आर नेट इम्पोर्टर ऑफ बैम्बू, वी आर नॉट एक्सपोर्टर। सरप्राइजिंगली इन इफ यू कंसिडर द ईयर बिटवीन 2015 टू 2018, टेक्निकली वी रीच टू अबाउट 10,000 करोड़ ऑफ इम्पोर्ट ऑफ स्टिक्स, बैम्बू स्टिक्स। सो दीज थिंग्स हैव टेकन केयर बाई गवर्नमेंट एंड दे कंसिडर, एंड थैंक्स टू दिस बैम्बू मूव नाउ फ्रॉम अ फॉरेस्ट टू ग्रास। एज पर 19 देर इज अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट वॉज देयर इन दैट एक्ट एंड 1927 फॉरेस्ट एक्ट। नाउ यू कैन, आई मीन इफ यू योर बैम्बू इज नॉट फ्रॉम फॉरेस्ट, इफ यू आर ग्रोइंग इन योर फार्म, यू कैन कट इट, यू कैन ट्रांसपोर्ट इट, यू कैन सेल इट एनी वेयर इन इंडिया। दिस वॉज समथिंग अ बिग बिग पॉलिसी चेंज। नाउ द बेस्ट थिंग इज नाउ बैम्बू कैन बी कट डाउन and can be used. We are getting a lot of bamboo from Northeast nowadays, so market is a little bit stabilized, a lot of things are coming, but still there is a huge problem of raw material, real huge problem, because we are dependent on Northeast, Central India. These are the main source of bamboo supply. But if you consider the remaining other part of India, even Eastern India once upon a time was rich in bamboo. Now states like Bihar, Odisha, Jharkhand, they are not that rich now. They are also getting bamboo from outside. So the good thing is that the good news is now farmer can cultivate on bamboo and without any problem can sail anywhere. So that's why nowadays we are suggesting bamboo cultivation. And if you see the market, it's a raw material, industrial raw material consists like this. About less than 10%, but in industrial product, if you combine industrial product and industrial raw material, this is more than 33% of the total demand of bamboo. Furniture, see, it's about 18 billion. 18 billion is a huge sum. Edible shoots, if you see, edible shoots is something also in the range of 18 billion, 15 to 18 billion. So it's a huge things are there. And we are not able to harvest, we are still importer. So now there is a time farmer should take interest, and now the India will become from importer to exporter in sector of bamboo. So this is a very good example. Actually, this is a hut, we can say it's a working office. it was made in 1955 in FRI, and still it is working. This is a very fresh photograph taken. And CCA treated, treated bamboo. What we say always, if you go with the treated bamboo, 55 years, 65 years on, and still we are getting, and this working office is going on. And very nicely, environmentally, this structure is very good. Temperature is very much controlled. You don't need air conditioning and other facilities. So the good part is how we can use in bamboo in construction. These are the glimpses of the some of the uses of bamboo. We will discuss in later part. Like these are furniture made from black bamboo, and like these are structures. If you see on the right top side, bamboo panels, bamboo lumbers. So now coming to why I'm saying it's a wonder plant. A wonder plant. The reason is, see, this is one of the most sustainable source for our material. Bamboo clumps, if you grow, when you plant in field, it takes 2 to 3 years to establish root, particularly root growth takes place and everything happens. Then after that, in third year onwards, you'll get thick shoots. Those are called rhizomes. Thick rhizomes come out, and those rhizomes are going to be important for economic point of view. And after 3 years, from 2 years plus, after fifth year, those are ready to harvest. And after that, you cut it, next year you are going to get more, next year you are going to get more, you are going to get more. So you don't have to replace the whole system. So bamboo, what the good thing is, you can sustainable take out, and your culm, and that is called clump. Clump is going to remain there, that continues rich enriching carbon, it continue sequestering carbon. Whatever you are taking out, you are still going to put more in that system, maintaining the system. So this is interesting thing about bamboo. If you see the graph, it's a height. So bamboo is only 5.5 months, 7 days. Bamboo reaches complete full height. After that, there is a plateau, very small increase. So about 95% height takes place in only 5 months. And after 11 months and 3 days, bamboo reach their maximum biomass. So I'll share with you, interestingly, do you know one thing? Bamboo grow and in first year completely, after that, bamboo never grows. In fact, bamboo don't have any lateral growth. So it shrinks a little bit, not much. Maybe it's a 2% to 5 to 10%, up to 10% in certain case, year-to-year basis. It consolidates, and water material reduces further. And there are certain lignin synthesis, then cellulose synthesis, and there's those two items takes place. And after 3 years, bamboo is completely mature. But that maturity, by that maturity, your biomass, if you consider by biomass or your the diameter of the girth or diameter of bamboo, that reduces slightly. But naturally, harvestable bamboo is after 3 years. When you harvest after 3 years, those bamboos have a very good market. You will have less insect attack on those bamboos. In certain case, you can use bamboo before 3 years, like basket trees. Basket tree, you need greener side of bamboo. So people are using less than even 2 years in a certain case. It's very easy to peel and make baskets. So this is how it happens. So in 1 year, if you in second year, and then third year, and the fourth year, growth takes place. So after sixth or seventh year, if you don't start removing bamboo, it is going to be a congestion in the clump, and your productivity is going to, you are going to lose your productivity. So better do very nice cultivation, keep removing, and then replenishing with the nutrients and other whatever required thing there. That we will discuss in the latter part of my presentation. So now we are coming to commercially important bamboos of India. So I'll discuss only those bamboo which is really important in India, because these bamboo have industrial uses and different uses there. So if you consider the size, so largest size bamboo is Dendrocalamus giganteus. Dendrocalamus giganteus can grow almost all region in India where rice is being grown. Bamboo have a preference of low pH, pH less than 7. That's why I always equated with rice, because rice also have a preference of the same pH scale. And one of the very good bamboo for furniture, handicraft, strip boards, edible shoots, charcoal, biomass, you name it. And in furniture market, still, it is one of the best bamboo being used everywhere in world, in fact, global scale. There is a huge demand of the furniture made from giganteus. Then another is Dendrocalamus asper. This is not Indian bamboo, but it is quite doing well in India. It's the second largest, one of the second largest bamboo. Same thing, it's a Thai and Thailand and Indonesian origin bamboo. And same uses are there. Worldwide, it is being used in several. Relatively, wall thickness is more than Dendrocalamus giganteus. Then Dendrocalamus brandesi. Dendrocalamus brandesi is a very good bamboo, being quite nicely. It's a Burma bamboo, and origin is Myanmar, but very nice doing in south part of India. Northern part, we have seen a little bit sensitive with cold. So growth is not as good as what it is doing in southern part of India, especially Western Ghat. Coming, it's also very huge bamboo. Then large size bamboo. Bambusa balcoa, versatile bamboo. Uses excellent biomass, very strong. You can consider it's a lathi bas. You must have, most of the people heard about lathi bas. So it is a very thick lathi bas, 3 inches diameter thickness. Is a normal in this bamboo, and almost up to 8 to 10 feet, it is almost solid in most of the cases. Uses are used mostly in biomass, all construction, bas, balli, poles, and everything. New uses are there nowadays. Industrial pallets, tiles, timbers, scrimbers. So these type of uses are coming. Bambusa balcoa have origin in northeast, and West Bengal, some part of Bihar and Orissa also it is being grown. And Bambusa vulgaris. Bambusa vulgaris is one of the widely distributed bamboo of India. It's a green vulgaris people used to call. Previously, there was one yellow vulgaris variety strata. Now it is a different species. So that is ornamental. But this one is green bamboo. Wall thickness is medium. Very good biomass, growth comes like anything. The best part of this bamboo have relatively survival ability in 7 and something just beyond above 7 also it survives well. Plasticity, I mean, where in across the India it grows very well. There is a Gigantochloa atrovalacea. It's a Javan black bamboo. It is also large bamboo category. It goes, I mean, more than 3 inches diameter. Sometimes it goes up to 4 inches. Used bamboo, ornamental, furniture, handicraft. Then Dendrocalamus somdevai. Dendrocalamus somdevai, it is hill bamboo, but very strong bamboo. Very much comparable to Bambusa balcoa in strength. But there is a lumen, I mean, there is a hole, but that hole is, despite that, it is quite good. And wall thickness goes up to about 3 centimeter wall thickness. So 3 to 4 centimeter it goes. So it's a very good wall thickness is there. And in certain case, we have seen more than 12 to 15 centimeter diameter. So Somdevai is a very good bamboo, grows up to 1500 or even we have report of 2000 meters. Joshimath area also we got some report. Normally it's very common in Himachal Pradesh and rarely, but in natural it is existing in Uttarakhand as well. It is called by name of Magar. So it's a thickest bamboo in temperate region of India. Then Bambusa tulda. Very versatile bamboo. I mean, one of the best bamboo for utility, for stick industry, brush, daily usable item, furniture. Even it's a moderately good for construction as well. Versatility is also very good. It has also survival ability in a different region, except there is a sensitivity in arid and saline and also temperate zone. But in subtropical zone, it grows very well. But you can grow. You can grow even in semi-arid area with irrigation and soil maneuvering. And normally, we have to go for soil maneuvering. pH, we have to balance using phosphoric acid or gypsum, or then you can use Bambusa Newtons. Same as Bambusa Tulda. It's also used bamboo. In fact, size-wise, it's bigger than Tulda. Preferred for a lot of uses. What it is used with the Tulda, same thing it is being, Newtons is also being used. Then Bambusa Polymorpha. Bambusa Polymorpha, Tulda, Newtons, Polymorpha all have a northeastern and Indian, eastern Indian origin bamboo. Polymorpha, you can have up to in natural from northeast to up to West Bengal. All these Tulda and Newtons you can have up to Bihar, Jharkhand, and Odisha as well in natural condition. So erstwhile Bambusa Polymorpha was used for agarbatti. It was the only one source for agarbatti industry once upon a time. Now it is being replaced by Tulda because internodal length of Tulda is better. And still it is very good for furniture, handicraft, and construction and other items. Small size bamboo, Dendrochilamus cestectus, lathi bas, the most distributed bamboo of India. About 45% of bamboo area is covered by Dendrochilamus cestectus. India has about 16 million area under bamboo. So just you can imagine, it is more than 7 million hectare it is in Dendrochilamus cestectus. Versatile. One of the strongest bamboo for construction, biomass, stake, charcoal, paper, pulp, wherever strength you need, it is being used. One interesting thing I would like to share in near Haridwar, one gentleman, he is cultivating it. Now he is cultivating in some 100 acres of this crop, and his estimate is per acre he is getting about at least lakh per annum. So using only Dendrochilamus cestectus, mostly supplying to stake, bas, balli, and those industries. Then Dendrochilamus stocksi, Konkan, one of the best bamboo growing in Sahyadri Hills or Konkan area in Maharashtra. Stocksi is straighter than cestectus. Internodal length also a bit bigger than cestectus. Nodes are relatively not that big. Like nodes in cestectus is big, so that hampers its use in especially furniture and those industry. So stocksi is easily it's being used in housing, furniture, and artifacts. And one of the nicest structure, one of our friend Dr. Steve, Mr. Engineer Sanjeev Karpe, he made one of the beautiful structure from Dendrochilamus stocksi. One of his structure, it is a bamboo pod restaurant in Waldorf Astoria in Maldives. Waldorf Astoria is one of the premium brand of Hilton. So that structure is one of the top rated waterfront restaurant in the world. Mostly used stocksi. So then Thyrsostachys aloveri, some bamboo has an origin in Myanmar. But very nicely, one of the most oldest cultivated bamboo of India. In Tripura, it is being cultivated, practice almost standardized by Tripuri's farmer. And for poles and several, especially it started with fish pole uses, but several uses it is being used for making hut and everything. It's coming very well in Tripura. So now we are coming to important part. It's a bamboo propagation. So this is how it looks. We are going to talk about today mostly symphorial bamboos. Because in India, we don't have many monopodial bamboo. There are two type of basically broader classification is sympodial and monopodial. Monopodial have grass-like spread. Runners grows quite long, and then you have knots after maybe 5 meter, 2 meter, 3 meter. One bamboo will come, then another 2 meter, you will have another bamboo. But in sympodial, it's a tufted. It's a closely from one main rhizome. You can see this is the main branch or culm, we say, and that from there rhizome buds origin and new rhizomes come out, and these are the roots, and these new rhizome finally completely grow in a full culm. Bamboo single stem is called as culm, and bamboo a group of the whole bamboo is called clump, the tufted, that closely linked. So this is how it looks like in a sympodial bamboo. So I mean, how we propagate bamboo? Many people are aware bamboo has a very strange phenomena. It flowers, and after flowering it dies. Mostly, in most of the case, it happens like that, except there are a few exceptions, but most of the bamboo, it happens like that. So gregarious flowering in Melocana, one of the picture you can see in the right left side, Melocana bassifera stem in 2006, and next year it flowered. By next year flowered, and after flowering the scene was like that. In Garo Hills, it was for picture was taken. It looks like if you can see in deep, there is a yellow area. So look like there is a burnt area is there. So it's not burnt. Basically, all bamboo shoot dies. Between 2004 to 2008, major flowering happened in Melocana bassifera woolly bass. And a lot of seed came, but the aftermath was like for 6-7 years you don't have many bamboo culm, because it takes 6 to 7 years to regain in natural condition. So there was a lull of bamboo between that period. So these are the type of seeds. This is Melocana on the right side top is a Melocana bassifera. Then on the left side it is a Caryopsis type of seed. Left side down is a Bambusa polymorpha. Then here are two type of seeds are there. One is it is Dendrochlamys. Normally Dendrochlamys has these type of seeds. Species may vary. So these are different type of Bambusa have different shape. Melocana has different shape. Melocana bassifera, sometimes there is a confusion. It is about like it is a monopodial. It is amphipodial. It behaves like monopodial sometimes, and it behaves like sympodial as well. So it has both amphipodial and monopodial type. So now we are coming to propagation. Next thing is always about when you do after seeds, there is a problem in bamboo. After 40 years, likelihood of flowering is there. It varies from some species you have 25 plus years, and some species more than 50 years. Some species we haven't seen recorded flowering for more than 100 years. So one thing is you can't depend on seed, because after certain time you are going to have some, I mean, if you want some plant, you have to depend on some other practices rather than seed, because seed storage is also very poor in bamboo. By all practices, we reach up to 2.5 years, but normal condition, the storage life is 3 to 4 months. So oldest macro propagation report is in 1899 by Mr. Pathak in Dendrochlamys strictus, when he got successful macro propagation. The second one was a big phenomena happened when Adarsh Kumar and team, he's a physiologist in FRI, and he developed a macro proliferation technique. In that technique, what you then can do, apart from seedlings and tissue cultured material, after 1 year you can separate it, and you can have multiplied plants like that. You can see here, you just divide it from the rhizome, because bamboo has a rhizome development activity. So from the rhizome you can split it. So splitting of rhizome is possible, and in the case of bamboos, rate of multiplication is 3.5 in one cycle. Normally more than one cycle you can do in a year. And in case of tulda, which is very difficult to macro propagate or vegetatively response of tulda is difficult, still rate is 2.5, so not bad. So multiplication, how we do multiplication strategies? So normally in case of macro propagation, we go for germplasm bank, establish germplasm bank, and from there we do macro propagation. Major techniques are rhizome and offset, one of the oldest technique, and then relatively new techniques are culm and branch cuttings. Then micro propagation, yes, in bamboo micro propagation is working wonders, and a lot of labs, they are producing tissue culture clones in large number, in millions number, and that is being used across India, not only India, worldwide. So macro propagation is the oldest technique. What I have shown you, this is rhizome and offset. What we do normally, we cut down the main the new, it's 1 to 2 years old culm, we cut down about one meter or 1.5 meter, and in next the season, in next rainy season, you expect new shoots coming out, and that new shoots are you can just remove that offset, that the material you cut down with that new shoot, and separately you plant. Normally what happens in this case, this is one of the fastest and very quickest mode of plantation, no doubt. But here you have to disturb the clump. So a lot of people, they don't like to disturb their clump because you are going to lose a shoot, or maybe one, more than one shoot. So, and then second thing happens, when you remove it, likelihood is there you are going to lose your micro rhizomes, which you expect to come out from that main offset. Main offset is this area. So normally dipping with 200 ppm Na, we have got 100% success while we are doing transplanting, because sometimes we have to move material from thousands kilometer. Like some material we got from Jorhat, some material we got from Ranchi, and some material we got from Jabalpur. So these are more than 1,000 or 2,000 kilometer places. So these are method we applied, and we got 100% success while we moved material. So another is culm and nodal cutting. So bamboo has a very bansuri vidhi. In some bamboo, which are hollow bamboos, so you can see in picture, what we do between internode, between two nodes, we drill it, and then we pour some. In this case, we are putting Na with sometimes boric acid with the same concentration, and fill it and seal it, plant it horizontally on the right side of the screen, you can see, cover it with the soil, and after 2 to 3 months, you expect some new shoots coming from the nodes. These are the nodes you expect, and then after that we separate it, and from the same node downside you expect sometimes roots, so we separate it and we plant it as a different plant. Only thing is, it requires a lot of area, and also it's you can only go for 2 to 3 year old culm, which is a marketable clump normally. So marketable culm, people sometimes they give, but sometimes they don't. Speed is relatively slow, but still you can do it. So this is a relatively faster one. This is, we are using single nodal cutting. So in single nodal cutting, what we see, you can see here, we, from the one node, this is the node normally, so 2 inch above the node and 2 inch below the node, we make a cut, put it down, and if there is already branchings coming out, we keep intact branches and dip it in Na. If we have to put overnight, normally in some species like Newtons, we do for 100 ppm or vulgaris 100 ppm, but in case of other species which is difficult to root, we go for more, 200 ppm overnight, or if we have to do it quicker, 500 to 1000 ppm Na for 1 hour. So result is like that. From this point you expect a new rhizomes is coming out, and that and then these roots are coming out, hairy roots, so you move it and plant it. This takes a little place as compared to the first one I mentioned. than branch cutting. Actually, branch cutting is a very good, you don't disrupt your bamboo. But the problem with branch cutting, you won't get branches in every bamboo. Only few bamboo have branches, like Newton's, Balcoa, they have branches in the lower part. So in that case, in strictures also you have, but the problem with the strictures, you won't get success. Success rate is very less. And then Dendrocalamus thombei, it is a moderately, you get result is there. And Bombay Dendrocalamus thombei, younger clumps normally usually have branches, but older clump they don't have. Normally the branches is shed after 2 years or 3 years. So here this is the example we use powders. So normally we used IBA and NA 4000 in talcum, especially for this Dendrocalamus strictures. For other like Balcoa, this is something like 1000 ppm to 4000 ppm, both NA and IBA in different concentrations. So plants are which are propagated now ready, and we maintain in shade house. Normally we harden it before planting. We keep we stop irrigation about 15 days before planting. We stop irrigation so that it is hardened and transferred to field. This is also, I already told you, a very fast way to multiply. Micropropagation have an opportunity. In case of Bambusa balcoa, my experience is 2 to 5 times in 2 weeks. In fact, 2 to 3 weeks, third week is for vulgaris and other species. So you rate of multiplication, you can just imagine. It is 2 to, so in a month, you have more than 10 times. In a next month, you have more than 100 times. In a next month, you have more than 10,000 times. So in 4 or 5 months, you can have from single planted easily. In practical experience is also there, like from a single material, I got more than 7 to 8,000 in a whole cycle of 7 to 8 months. Because after completion of cycle, you put on rooting. So these are one of our clone, Bambusa balcoa clone 585. It is being multiplied in our labs, and liquid culture makes wonder. Like this, this is only, this structure comes from a small to this much structure comes in 15 days. Rooting normally, like balcoa, they have preference in solid culture. So plants are ready, and this is relatively newly planted. This is 1 month or old. This is more than 2 to 3 months old. This is background 4 to 5 months old. So these are ready to kept out in field. So it is planted after 4 to 5 months. We plant in big polybags, and normal nursery practices we do, and finally we get multiplication. This is one of our clone DAS. It's a clone of Dendrocalamus asper, one very huge bamboo. So now we are coming to bamboo cultivation. Bamboo cultivation is the first thing. Kyun kare? Pehli baat hai ki karenge hi kyun? Market demand hai. So any farmer, I used to get, I'll also share my phone number in the end. So normally farmer ask ki sir mere ko bamboo karna hai, I want to do bamboo. From across the India people do ask. I say first question, why you do? First go ask for demand, whether demand is there or not. Because naturally, if you are going to farm at small scale, 1 acre or 2 acres, you are not going to start to supply in industry or something like that. So go for local demand. So kaun sa bamboo bazaar mein bikta hai, which type of bamboo required? Normally there are 3-4 bamboo that is being sold in market. So how it is being sold, is it by weight? Normally if you sell bamboo, it goes by pole size, not by weight. But for biomass and other industry, it goes by weight. So you have to very clear what, and like for farmers, normally I have a suggestion. If you are going for, don't go for weight, because you are not going to get market for weight. But if you are growing Bambusa balcoa and others, naturally you are going to sell the bigger industry like paper and pulp and energy production or charcoal. So there you have to sell by weight. So for handicrafts and furniture industry, tulda, gigantius, black, ringal is a hill bamboo, very thin but very nice things you can make out of that. Aurea is Phyllostachys aurea. It is a runner bamboo and not very tall. It is only 3 meter tall, but nicely used in different type of small handicraft work. Fish pole, earlier umbrellas, handles, that was used from aurea. Then stick industry, that is using tulda, Newton's mozo. Mozo is a Chinese bamboo. In India also it is being grown in temperate condition because this is a temperate bamboo. So normally we don't have temperate area, much temperate area. We have less than 5% temperate area in India. So we have more subtropical bamboo around. Already discussed for construction and biomass, pole, bowl, balli, sticks, balkhua, somdevai and lathi. And bamboo sheet, weep product, Hamiltonii, Muli, Kalos, Cephalostachys, Polymorpha. And second question is how far is market? Because as if your market is far, naturally you have to pay a lot of price for transportation. So it is not going to be a very nice venture. So naturally I suggest try to make a cluster. So at least from one side you can get more than a truck of bamboo at one time and you can sell and supply in different markets. I'll discuss this thing in further coming slides. So now bamboo, if you have to cultivate germplasm, from where you will get material? Get only from certified supplier. I'll tell you one thing. In earlier age, it's very difficult to identify bamboo to bamboo. Last few years, a lot of people are there around. They are cheaters. They sell even kata bans to in the name of tulda or any bamboo because you don't know. So there are certified very nice suppliers also there. They are very working hard. They work in tandem with agriculture universities. They work in tandem with National Bamboo Mission, which is the umbrella organization for this. They work with the certification process. So try to get and take at least whatever you take in writing. Like this is the bamboo. And this is the bamboo we are going to get. I know a lot of one or two people in Maharashtra, that person especially playing havoc. They just treated farmers like anything. And farmers are now crying because they are getting kanta mas. That person sold bamboo in the name of mozo. It's a silly. In Maharashtra, you won't get mozo. It's a tropical condition. So beware. And always, whenever you have stress, you go to nearest agriculture college, nearest KVK, or even forest department people. They will help you. There are several bamboo group around India. They will help you. They will make contact of the people. Or you can contact me, Forest Research Institute, Director of Forest Research Institute. You can write mail to any of the Forest Research Institute in India, any TFRI, Rainforest Research Institute. So you write it and you'll get help. Sure, I will get help. So now we are coming to which type of bamboo. Naturally, bamboo has very strange thing, especially bamboo has a rest period, especially tropical bamboo in summers. If you notice, you realize mostly in before the rainy season, bamboo has a complete 1 and 1 month, 1 and a half month resting period. In certain case, bamboo has 2 resting period, like winter as well as in summer. And this happens mostly in tropical bamboo, but in temperate bamboo things are different. They have a strong winter rest period, because rest period is indicated by a shoot emergence. And next year, immediately after rest period, you will get new shoots, and that shows like which is the rest period. The previous period, 1 month or 2 months or 4 months, it's a rest period. So during winter, if you have germplasm, still you have to care. You store it under shade if you are not planted. If you plant it, normally if it is going to be a severe winter, then wrap it with newspaper, and even you can put some cloth or rag material for 1 year or something like that. If there is a cold temperature, I'm just talking about something the temperate places like Haryana, some place of Rajasthan, Punjab, the temperature goes up to 0 degrees. So you have to be careful in that area. And other area, it's okay because you won't get a temperature anything less than 7-8 degrees. So that's not going to be a problem. So this is a flow chart I made. This is like how you plan. Flow chart says if you start in summer, pit size, I always suggest go for bigger pit size. If you use JCB, no problem, very nice. But at least you use auger on those things, mechanical auger, so that you have a huge pit size. It helps. In long run, it helps in growth of bamboo. Then to solarize the soil, normally these exercise we do after spring or during summer season, and keep soil outside so that it get quite solarized and heat, it get received heat. First year when we, I mean the 0 year, I mean when we plant, we put one bucket, at least one bucket compost, 25 gram urea, 100 gram DAP or 125 gram MOP. Bamboo loves potassium, so bamboo has a better demand for potassium. And if you have don't have this these things, you can go in market, there is available 12 32 16, so you can go for that, and with addition of muriate of potash. Or if you don't have, or I mean less compost, then half a bucket of compost you can use, 100 gram neem khali. If you don't have neem khali, go for mustard. Then in that case you go 20 gram urea, 50 gram DAP, 100 gram MOP, or these are options you have. I always suggest initially you put bevestin and diethin if you can use. If you are going for organic, then there are some other, that is in detail, you contact with expert only. And you have to keep fertilizing it. Mind it, if you are going bamboo in field, you are going to go give some input. So after 3-4 years, you go continuously develop. Then there is a certain exercise you have to do even after 3 years. We will discuss in later. So this is in detail what I discussed, because maybe the last slide was not that clear to all. So I kept that. Now I guess it is okay. Okay, so how we do in next spring, because there is in northern part of India, you receive quite good rain in spring. So in there also, and in the other part of India where is the no rain, normally go with some for this irrigation, and you can use these things. Especially I suggest soluble fertilizers, 1 gram urea plus 1 gram 18-18-18 or 19-19-19, whatever available you have. You must put 1 gram 1 milliliter humicil also. It increases CEC, increases movement of points in, so it's very easy for bamboo. So spacing is one very important thing I'll discuss in detail, in fact. So here is a planting species normally I suggest, largest bamboo. If you are doing normal practices where with normal input, then it is 8 by 8 meter. Certain times you can go for 8 by 6 meter as well. With intensive, people are using, in Maharashtra I know a lot of people, they are using with drip. Go in that case, go with closure spacing 6 by 6. But in case of when you have input is very very high. And here you can per hectare 160 to 280, 65 to 110. So whenever nursery person, sometimes they will tell you 1 acre, 1,000 plant. Never go. It's a huge number. You're going to waste your money and as well as maintenance cost. Your maintenance cost will increase. You're going to lose. So ask any expert. Whenever any nurseryman suggest go for very closure spacing, don't straight away say no, I need only 200 or something like that. So in case of diaspora, it is like this. In large size bamboo, 400 to 440 per hectare and 160 to 180 per hectare. Again, this I am suggesting for plains. In undulating place, it may vary. Sometimes you can increase, it depends on the land slope. So large bamboo like Balkhoa, vulgaris, black bamboo, Somdeva, it is Vespasian. And Bambusa tulda, Bambusa nutans, it's a medium-sized bamboo, Bambusa polymorpha. You can go for a little bit closer spacing if you are doing intensive cultivation. 400 to 500 numbers per hectare, 160 to 200 numbers per acre. And a smaller size bamboo like Dendrocalamus strictus, stock size, or Thysostachys oliveri, number, spacing may vary. 3 to 4 meter standard is, and because after three years the congestion will take place, and after that congestion naturally bamboo roots spread like anything, and then one bamboo is going to compete with another bamboo, and there is a problem, there is that the whole new culm growth will slow down. So I suggest go for the suggested spacing, and if you have any change in plant, must discuss with any expert what I suggested. Any people nearby, any agriculture university, any VVK, any forest people. So, or and there are very nice growers. Actually, growers are one of the best. They suggest, they learn, and then they suggest to others also. So, and watering bamboo, I always say it loves water. But always keep in mind, if your water is stagnant for more than 5 or 10 days, then it is going to be difficult, and in certain case there is a death of the plant also, it happens. So drainage also should be very nice, regular watering. If you keep watering through channels, you can go up to 7 to 11 shoot per year after 3 years. It is in case of Bambusa vulgaris I have seen. And regular watering, and you have different uses of bamboo. So return you expect after 3 years onward always in thinner bamboo. Especially the thinner bamboo you can use, people do come for stakes, especially tomato and climbers like all cucumbers and Karela and all sugar, I mean cucurbitaceae family we say, kadu, ghia, and those crop you can take on that. So this is this is from Bambusa vulgaris. So how it happens, in 1 year the size you'll get 3 meters or like that. So after 5 years your bamboo start getting size of more than 10 meter. So by maturation, I say in bamboo there is a period, 1 to 2 year, 2 to 3 year is a childhood period, 3 to 8 years it's a teenage period, and after 9 years bamboo got a real peak. So size started getting something in the range of, all culms goes off a height of about 13 meter, 14 meter, in certain case it goes to 18 meters as well. Same thing happens with the bamboo girth or diameter. This green one is harvestable one, because you start harvesting after 5th year. So harvestable size is 3 centimeter or something like that, but actual the marketable size more than 8 centimeter you get after 7-8 meters if you are doing in normal cultivation. But again, this is, I'm saying, it's a standard normal. With very good input you get better result. So how we do, after 5 to 6 year up to 10 years, average is you get 5 culms per clump. So expected annual return is about 2500 culms, and normally when you do the medium size bamboo, and here is weight wise you have more than 25 tons per green weight per hectare, standard deviation is plus minus 20%, culm is 2500. Weight you will fetch like here I told you 2500, but not every bamboo is going to be the market standard. Hardly 40 to 50% initially you'll get going to get a market standard. After 7-8 years, your market standard bamboo, like 3 inches thickness, bullet size, you'll get after 7-8 years, 70-80% bamboo will reach like that. So this is the commercial scenario of the commercial bamboo market. Now in Northeast India, it is sold by mostly by culm, and specific trade names are there. Bullet is like trade name is Bullet, Deluxe, Super, Core. So Bullet is usually normally called to bamboo having 7.2 meters or 24 feet or 3 inches thickness at the base. Normal price, I mean, this is the, this year season price is Alipur Dwar or Marpeta. It is between 60 to 70. Maybe you'll get up to 55, depend on the quality. Lending price in Delhi is around 110 to 120. Retail price in Delhi, it is something around 150 to 160. And smaller sizes, price reduce like this. And this is the bullet is mostly I'm talking about one from the medium size. Balkhua has even higher size. Even in Alipur Dwar, Balkhua, you get it in between 90 to 110. So price increases because Balkhua carry less in number. So price increases in Delhi and other places more. And this is how it is. It's after 2+ years in my garden where I'm growing. It's a species come clonal trial. So Asper is growing like this. This is clone number 585. You can see the thickness, it's on my hand. So plus after 2+ years, this is the thicker stem you expect. And this is vulgaris. Strangely, vulgaris we are getting in 2+ years, 14 culms per shoots per after 2 years. So it's a huge growth wise, I can say I recommend it. Now I'm coming to final part, it is utilization. A broad utilization we will discuss. Many use, more than 1500 uses are there. I'll show you some of the uses. This is scrimber. If you see, this is a scrimber of bamboo scrimber board, very thick, very hard, harder than your brick. So this is out of bamboo. Bamboos are dendrocnamous sundewi, and this is called OSB. This is oriental strand board. Oriental strand board is you put strands, put it some resin after treating. So these are the industrial thing. Here you can see these are the handicraft item. I'll show you one strange thing. This is strip. This is being a strip. It's a outer strip of bamboo. And in market, people are using plastic, and we are importing most of the plastic from China. So these are the material already available to put in furniture industry or those industry, and you can easily put there. So here you can see already in my slide, it's a construction ladder, scaffolding. These are the bar area. These are the furniture. This one is the courtesy, one of my friend, Dr. Engineer Sanjeev. And this one is Mr. Pulaha Dasgupta. He's also a very great designer, especially expert designer and consultant in bamboo, good friend, senior friend. And these are the bamboo in stakes. Very strange story, I come to this stake. Actually, the first NBM, the NBM which is going on before this, that was under part of National Horticulture Mission, because there is a huge dearth of bamboo in farmer's field, huge dearth of bamboo. You grow bamboo, most of the people will come for their tomato cultivation. And there is an example I'll show you. Dehradun supply dahlia plants, about more than one crore dahlia plant around the across the northern side of India. And each dahlia plant that goes with the 1-2 foot stick, that foot stick cost between 60 paisa to 80 paisa. Just imagine, 1 crore with 1 crore plant multiplied by 0.6, it is something like 60 lakhs. So these are things told by the growers, the nursery people, they are saying like we are getting the material and we are paying in lakhs for this material. These are the bamboo structure being used in ornamental sector. So bamboo fences, huge market. These are the bamboo, different type of bamboo used from top to bottom, different type of lumbers, OSB. I have shown you OSB. The one I am using here, it's a lumber. Lumber is very strong bamboo outcome. It is going to replace, coming time, it is going to replace wood. So fence is a huge. Then how we are going to, forget this food, bamboo shoots. Bamboo shoot has more than 18 billion market. 18 billion is a huge money. Just multiply it 18 billion and it will come to 70-80, I mean, it's a huge money, it is a real huge money, 70-80,000 crores or something like that. So these are the use of bamboo shoots. It's how you put it, slash it, shredded it, make it pickles, can it, use in any vegetable. In India, it is being used in the central part of India, northeast India, eastern India, and southern India. Northern India, we don't have developed taste yet, but people are coming because bamboo shoot is considered as a immunity booster as well. It's a black bamboo. Actually, I'm coming to black bamboo because this is my practical thing I'm going to share with you. But before that, this is one of the structure we made from the jacinto cloa hydrolysia. Plenty of you are using this type of thing for your horticulture practices. So this is soilless culture, NFT, by using NFT method and making hole in this 5 feet long stems of Dendrocalamus jacintius we made. And I was told by one of my friend, like, this structures even cost more than 30,000, and here we got in some, you know, in some thousand. It's nicely working. Bamboo loves water, so even bamboo material, if you use bamboo, only bamboo has a problem with soil. So since it's a soilless culture, this structure goes more than 5 years or 6 years if you maintain properly and you grow. And the best part of this, if you are removing the plastic, you maintain temperature, because I have seen people are using a soilless culturing, I mean, growing vegetables, but in summer, naturally in Delhi, condition in Haryana, temperature in plastic that goes about, water temperature goes like 40-50 degree, but in bamboo it maintained quite up to 35 to 40, so it's quite enough to cultivate. So these are furniture we made. This is our in-house developed furniture from black bamboo, and it's a natural color. Actually, you don't color it. This is the one bamboo that remained, it colors intact, it colors for quite long time. I mean, I have never seen faded it. More than 8 years I have never seen faded it. So these are the bamboo we are making, because furniture is one area I'm very keen. If you consider, again, this is more than 16 or 18 billion market till date. In India also, IKEA is coming. IKEA has committed about more than 300 crore furniture from bamboo furniture from India by 2022. Then there are other players. So we expect our market growing. These are the, inside the structure of this, what we use for curtain hangers. We can replace and have more aesthetic value. So these are the bamboo cups, bamboo handicraft item. Mostly I use from black, but you can do with other bamboo. Bambusa polymorpha, you can use like chulda, then no doubt this your Dendrocalamus jacintius. You can use even asper also. So these are bamboo petal. Earlier time I have developed. Now I am not developing because a lot of people in Tripura and those there doing very nice bamboo. But my earlier, about two years back, I developed this thing. Very nice, but it's a different sector. A lot of people they are doing. Let them do. But I mean, we are discussing about like how it is going to be important in rural development. Yes. You can grow there, you can make it, you can value-add it, because farmer in India, we are growing crop, we have still plenty of time. We employ that time in value addition, and then finally we go to commercial production. So this is one of the products, this is a dyes we made for our own uses. And this I would like to mention. You can see this guy is one of the biggest grower of mushroom, and one of my friend helped to develop. This is a huge structure. This is, you can see this structure is about 5 meter huge structure for mushroom growing, and these are loaded mushroom, and it's a huge structure. So I mean, just you can replace steel, and this is, if you are growing around, you can replace the steel, and this is huge market. So stakes, stick structures, there is use in different agriculture accessories, etc. So by this, I'm going to thank you. Thank you. This is with my original place where I work. This is the main building of Forest Research Institute, One Anusandhan Sansthan. And my phone number is 94101509 81. This is WhatsApp number, and I do prefer to discuss on WhatsApp mostly after 6 PM because daytime and office time sometimes is very difficult. So I comfortably deal and comfortably discuss. I happy to and welcome to discuss with all grower interested person to discuss on that. My email ID is thakura@icfre.org, and also you can get my number from Dr. Sanjeev, Dr. Dwivedi, and I'm thankful to Hot Talk and Progressive Horticulture, Dr. Dwivedi, and Mr. Shiv. He is helping me to organizing and doing this all thing. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you a lot, sir.
So